So now we're going to meditate, to look at the wheel of karma. We're going to do this meditation to see how a certain element of our lives affects us. This can be another being, which can be in human form, in spirit form, in animal form, in plant form. It can also be an activity, your job, playing chess, playing tennis, reading books. It can also be an internal activity, certain thoughts or feelings. Our consciousness is not wide enough to see all of it at once, but we can look at different aspects of our lives to see how they influence us karmatically. So focus on some element in your life and close your eyes. Try to see the object of your meditation clearly and focus on your heart, in a way the axis of the wheel of karma, your enlightened spirit. When your enlightened spirit comes in touch with this element of your life, the wheel of karma will start to move because you have a karmatic bond with this other. It doesn't mean that the other is what you perceive it to be, but this is how it is affecting you, the role it is playing for your spirit. So first, we will look at the element of anger. The element of anger has a lot of gradations. It can be stimulating to disagree, it can be irritating to disagree, it can be aggravating to disagree. Anger can be hot. You want to do something, or even worse, it can be cold, a loathing that you want to have nothing to do. Feel. What is your feeling towards the other? Is it a hot anger or a cold anger? What is the depth and the size of the anger? It is difficult if you're doing this meditation for the first time to accurately gauge the feelings or the sensations you're getting. But as you do this meditation more and more, you will gain more and more insight and understanding of how the outside world is influencing your enlightened spirit. Then we look at the second segment. The segment of desire, of lust, of hunger, of need. And feel how big is the need which exists between you and the other. Is it mainly your need or is it their need? And is it a need which can be sated? Do you get anywhere by fulfilling each other's needs? Or is it just an addiction or a pastime? This can be hard to determine. But if you look at this segment and look at the needs, and sometimes feel like if the need is not fulfilled, does the wheel stop spinning? And if it is fulfilled, does it spin more quickly? Does the vibration rise? Then it is a need which is helping you to develop. But the opposite can also be true. Some needs, if you fulfill them, they will make the spirit spin more slowly, to drag it down, to slow it down. Then it is merely an addiction which needs to be gotten rid of. Then we will look at the next segment, the segment of habit, of ritual, of instinct. How strong is this segment between you and the other? Does it grant you stability and rest to have these things? Or is it trapping you and dumbing you down that you stop thinking about things? Again, you can observe it by feeling, is your heart quickening or slowing? Then we look at curiosity, the will to explore, to experience new things. How stimulating is the other? How mysterious are they? Are they stagnant or are they ever changing and therefore always enchanting you? How are you to them? Are you stagnant and boring? Or are you stimulating? Ambition. What effect is the other having on your ambitions? Do you feel more ambitious or less because of them? Are they distracting you or helping you? Encouraging you? Are you cooperating? This ambition, or are you in conflict, competing? Is this competition constructive or destructive? Sometimes we feel that competition, that our rivals are a bad thing, they're our enemies. By doing this meditation, you will often see that our rivals may be our biggest benefactors. Then we come to the last segment, that of contentment, satisfaction. Do you feel at peace with each other? Can you rest with each other? Mm. And is this a good thing? Which gives your spirit time to process everything else going on, to strengthen and balance itself? Or is this a trap lulling you asleep inside a very satisfied ego? Now that we've looked at all these segments, try to look at the wheel itself. Is it standing still, moving slowly, or spinning? Is it a stimulating force, or a force which slows you down? Is it pulling you upwards? Or is it pulling you downwards? You can make conscious choices to work with the wheel within yourself, and thereby redefine the relationship you have with the other. And feel if you have a desire that the wheel should spin faster or should move upward. What segment of the wheel draws you in? Where should you focus your attention? What should you change to help your spirit rather than hinder it? Do these segments your attention is drawn to go into these and try to feel, what is this new feeling? This new relationship you want to experience with the other. What is the shift which is needed in your relationship to lighten the karma? Make it more satisfactory to the spirit and less of a hindrance in the path of enlightenment. That of your intention, invite your allies in that part of the wheel to help you to make that change. Because the desire to change is the force inside of you. You need to make your desire also a force outside of you. You have allies who will help you on this path, support your change, keep you on the right course. And this way, we can learn to deal with everything in our lives in a manner as beneficial as possible to our spirit. Not so much by manipulating the environment, but by changing our relationship with these things in our environment. Sometimes you may become aware that something should may perhaps no longer be in your life because it served its purpose. Then it is okay to let go, to make room for new things to come into your life, to enter your sphere of consciousness. If you notice that there are many things in your life which are holding you back, or dragging you down, putting you in a lower vibration, then maybe it is time to let go, to clean up, and abandon the things which are no longer fruitful, no matter how accustomed you've grown to them, no matter how much you enjoy them or long for them. Because you're here to serve the movement of your spirit. You're not here to serve the wheel of karma. but to use it.